Hi everyone, my name is Anne Marie, and in 2016 I was taken out of my body and out of body experiences that would be classified as the visions in the Bible. Okay, John the Revelator experienced this to write the book of Revelation. Also Daniel did as well, and also Paul and Peter talk about visions that they saw. Okay, so to get this message out to you, I've suffered a great deal since it came to me in 2016. I've had to leave apartments, a kid, and jobs. I'm getting my child back. But and the Bible talks about that. It talks about those who have to leave things for his name's sake. But the enemy came after me to murder me, because this is big time what I experienced. And he knows getting this out to you could save your life and save your soul. Jesus could save your soul before you have to experience these things. I was shown the Great Tribulation, okay? Very specific details about the Great Tribulation. And it was in our generation, our lifetime. That's the way I can describe it to you. My family and me had been taken off the earth, okay? We're believers. We followed Christ, you know? And this is what I saw left behind. It looked like the Hunger Games. That's how I can describe it to you. Your thoughts and your heart had to be on Jesus Christ, number one. If you still were worldly, even after we had left, God was giving a chance to the people that were on earth, but it was very, very hard. Because as soon as your thoughts got polluted by something in the world, you would be harassed and possibly murdered by fallen devils, the fallen ones, demons. Okay, they were playing games with mankind. They were hunting them. Everything looked as it did now, but there was devils everywhere on the street. And the way to escape the wrath of them was to praise Jesus, bless his name, be studying the Bible. Anyway, even if you didn't have a Bible, anything you remember as a child, any verse you remember, any Bible story, just setting your heart on Jesus and your thoughts. This is an example. There was one woman left behind, and the devils had blown a whistle. They were taunting mankind. And she started to think about her money over God, and she was pulling backwards to the pit. They took her to the pit. Okay, I saw the devils chasing mankind everywhere. I saw martial law and demonized soldiers and demonized police coming into houses with machine guns and pulling, you know, they got people out and were putting them in places. So you had no control, okay? The Bible says when these things happen that Jesus will hide those people in the mountains. I know the Jews will be hidden in the mountains. And you wanted to praise Jesus. You wanted to get right with him right away when this happened, because your thoughts, they could analyze your thoughts. These creatures knew your thoughts. And the Spirit of God wasn't there. It was like very, very cold. But Jesus still still had his hand in on earth. You know, he still was seeking those who really wanted to be right with him. Like I could see youth left behind, teenagers left behind. There was no children. I didn't see anybody under the age of 12. Give or take, but I saw high school kids left behind, and they were just really in fear, like they didn't, you know, and they just had, you know, they just looked like they were in shock. Okay, so yes, if you are not don't have Jesus as your personal Savior and following the commandments, the first one especially, keep loving the Lord God with your whole heart, soul, body, and mind, you could be left behind. Because listen, God's kingdom is about love. It's about, and then putting, loving your neighbor as yourself, loving your brother and sister as yourself. Okay, you got to keep your heart pure towards God. So this is the people that were left behind. They had put their mind on something else, worldly. Okay, they weren't serving God with all of their heart, soul, body, and mind. But let's get back to it. So I saw demonized police just busting in houses. There was like little toys of car, little kids toys and their belongings all left behind. You know, so all the believers had been taken off the earth. And I also saw people worshiping this beast, young people, even like in their 20s, they were under a strong delusion, and they had taken the mark of the beast, the RFID implant, and they were all worshiping this beast, and they were blaspheming God, and they were saying, look at God, his face. They had the wrong idea of who God was completely. So they were all worshiping the beast, and they were all of one delusion. So there was this group that was all just praising this beast as he was leading them. And they had lost the raid. They had lost their soul. I don't know if they were ever Christians to begin with, but they had lost it. They had received the mark of the beast. So there was many things going on. You know, martial law, demonized military. And then you've got people that received the mark of the beast. And then you've got people that are in shock, that are scared to death. And if you are left behind, you want to set your heart and mind on Jesus right away and think nothing of anything worldly, or think nothing of what's, you know, just keep your mind focused, because that was the way to fight it, was that God knew the people that wanted to be saved. He was still looking after them, but now they had work to do in themselves and prayer. What the Lord just spoke to me is praying. Prayer. So I saw also demons running down the street, and they were going into the houses of people who were left behind, and they were just running in there, murdering the people left behind in their homes who'd rejected Jesus. They'd rejected his message, and they had full access to your homes. There was no safety. The only there was safety putting your praying to Jesus. So I just want to tell you that it is soon too, because it was in our lifetime. So that's what I saw, and I'm gonna, you know, work out the fine details. But I hate horror movies, but it really did remind me of like The Others or The Hunger Games, and it was real, folks. And I also saw visions of hell. I saw people from earth, like Patrick Swayze. He's one that you all would know. I saw him in hell. This was during another outer body experience. Vision, I classified as a vision. I saw him being tortured horrendously by demons. Okay, they were throwing things at him in hell. And so, you know, this is real, folks. Hell is real. You know, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord as a believer. So I really pray that you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and then keep his commandments. God came to fulfill the commandments. You know, we are saved by grace. If we if we make a mistake, then the grace covers us. But God still wants us to keep his commandments, okay? So put God first, love your neighbor as yourself, and ask God to purify your heart. You know, we can tell when something, when we're holding bitterness or unforgiveness or anger, you can feel it. You can feel tension. Get on your knees and pray to God. Say, deliver me. Surrender your full heart. Surrender your self-will to God too. Okay, God has the best plan for your life. And remember, the Bible says, whoever shall lose his life for my name's sake shall gain it, and whoever shall gain his life shall lose it. So we can't be attached to anything in this world. We cannot. And God has spoken to me about lusting, lust of the flesh, and immorality and idolatry, and even in the body of Christ. Okay, so if you want to go with God up in the rapture, you've got to come out of all that stuff. You've got to come out of it. It's a form of demon worship. A lot of times, something that we listen to that's secular, something that we see, it's a form of demonic activity. It comes through the music, the secular music, especially now where we're in the end of the end days. Okay, so be careful what you put into your mind, okay? And just, this is a time of purification, and God is perfecting us in holiness, and it's also a time of improvement, God told me. So we're being taken. You might wonder, well, why am I not at the next level? There's something that you've asked for, and it hasn't happened for you yet. Maybe that you thought you were going to get a church, or maybe you thought you were going to get a bonus or something like that, because the saints are in a time of improvement. Okay, it will happen for you, but keep in prayer and keep seeking. Okay, and also God told me that he gave me the word ripe. Now, what I believe he means about that is the wheat and the tares are ripe. So the wheat is God's children, and they are ripe, but the tares are the devil's children, and they are ripe. And remember, in the end times, we all grow up together. That's in the New Testament. So we're all growing up together, and we've been, the wheat has been sown by God, and then the tares have been sown by the devil. So we've got a big division in our society now. So, God has got the angels or the reapers, and the angels are eventually going to come down and tie the devil's children up in bundles and throw them in the fire. And then the angels are going to put the God's children in the barn and to be with God forever. Okay, folks, so we are in the end of the end days. So let's just be prepared. Love you.